Well, joining us now is the CEO of SandboxAQ, Jack Hidary. His company was named one of Time Magazine's 100 most influential companies in 2025. And he's the author of Quantum Computing, an Applied Approach. He joins us now. And Jack, it's good to have you. I think you
Becky,
and I were both
here
in Saudi Arabia last week. And
that's
I was hoping
right
to speak to you then. So I'm glad that we've caught up with you here in the UAE. I want to discuss this announcement by Microsoft and how you view this sort of US UAE sort of critical public-private sort of power-broking partnership, as it were. First, just lay out for our viewers what your company does and explain quantum AI in a way, please, that everybody watching this show, and I'm not undermining their intelligence, but AI computing is hard to get your head around, so just lay out what you do so that all of us can understand it.
Well, great to be here, Becky, in Abu Dhabi with you. You're absolutely correct. This is the convergence right now of two massive rivers coming together, AI and energy, coming right here together at ADIPEC. Very exciting to see. For us at SandboxAQ, A for AI, Q for quantum, two of the engines that are transforming our world. So why do we need both AI and quantum? The AI that we do, we're at the forefront of a new kind of AI. People, our viewers here today, are familiar with AI for the digital world. AI like large language models, Gemini, ChatGPT, wonderful tools to summarize documents, to do research, to do marketing, customer service, great applications. But here at ADIPEC, we're talking about the physical world. We're talking about the need for new power generation. We're talking about the need for new kinds of battery chemistry. That is not a large language model task. That's a model that for an AI that knows chemistry, that knows physics, that knows the world. These are large quantitative models. So the AI that Sandbox is the leader in is the AI for the real world. As Jensen talks about, NVIDIA, one of our investors, AI for the physical world.
Well, you're backed by NVIDIA, as you point out, and Google, who've supported you, as I understand it,
that's
to
right
the tune of some $150 million in investment. Explain that partnership for us and why you're offering these large quantitative models, or LQMs, are more useful than the sort of LLMs that perhaps the rest of us, you know, hear most about when it comes to sort of ChatGPT and Gemini and stuff.
When it comes to energy, like here at ADIPEC, or it comes to pharma, we want to make a new medicine, for example, for cancer. Last week, we announced at FII the announcement with Bahrain. Bahrain and SandboxAQ announced a partnership to discover new drugs for cancer, for diabetes, for other key areas, using this new kind of AI, an AI that is trained on molecules, not on cat images. And so this is the kind of AI that we need to really hit the rubber meets the road in the physical world.
Can I ask you about this sort of partnerships that we are seeing evolving, not least, for example, the partnership between the US and the UAE. This
yes
is a multi-billion dollar
fundamental partnership.
Going both ways.
Yes.
As part of that, of course, Microsoft's original $1.5 billion investment in G42, the big AI holding company here. Today we hear further investment from Microsoft to the tune of some $15 billion over the next sort of 4 years. There is a broader surge in these sort of public and private partnerships coming together, these sort of power-broking sort of opportunities in this AI and energy arms race at present. What are you making?
I think we're going to see more and more of this. When you think about the UAE, UAE is very, very forward thinking. When the LLMs first hit the scene with ChatGPT, which was the first country outside the United States to create their own large language model, UAE, with the Falcon, that has become A71, a wholly independent company right now that is offering LLMs. And then G42, which is the primary vehicle of AI right here in the UAE, really took the lead, not only in terms of the software side, thinking about how to apply AI to the country of UAE, but also the infrastructure side. How do we get the energy needed for the data centers, and how do we put all that together, not just inside the UAE? Here's what's interesting about G42. They think globally. They're active with global partnerships. Yes, with the US, but also with other countries as well. So when Brad Smith came here about a year ago to announce the $1.5 billion, no surprise to us, and now Brad is here again, and he doubled down now, more than doubled down, with now this $15 billion announcement. $7 billion already in and committed, and now a new $8 billion commitment as well. I think we're going to see more of this, Becky.
I spoke last week with the CEO of Humane, which is Saudi Arabia's new massive bet on AI, building, you know, they're looking at this, you know, full end-to-end stack, data centers, cloud, you know, models, apps. You've, of course, worked with G42, the UAE's vehicle here. How do you see this region's role in this increasingly rich and compelling story that is AI?
Yeah. Well, I think that this region now realizes the power of AI, both on the digital side, but also on the physical side. Humane, which you mentioned, just came recently together. A great initiative in Saudi Arabia. Tariq Amin, who used to be the CEO of Aramco Digital, of course, is now the CEO of Humane, along with George Nazi and others. Really strong leadership there, led by MBS, to really make sure Saudi's on the map. They see what UAE is doing. They understand that. They want to have their vehicle. You're seeing Bahrain make deals, you're seeing Qatar, others. And so this is a region that really understands that nexus between energy and AI, but also moving AI to help their own people. When you think about the 400 million people in this region, think about their healthcare needs. There's been a strong commitment here. Just a few minutes away from here is the Cleveland Clinic, Abu Dhabi. Mm-hmm. Why is Cleveland Clinic here? Why is that partnership here? That goes back 10 years now. Mm-hmm. And now you see the UAE doubling down on longevity, on wellness, and these kind of areas. They're really forward thinking in terms of how do we use technology to transform our lives. And this is something that we don't necessarily see in other regions of the world. I think though, with this kind of announcement of Microsoft in UAE, of ourselves in Bahrain, we're gonna start seeing more of these public-private initiatives that really transform regions.
Which I think I'm going to have to leave it here because we've run out of time. But it's
great.
Fantastic having you on. Thank you
great
very much.
Great to see you, Becky.
Not only to hear about your own company, but your insight and analysis on kind of the wider story of energy and AI is fascinating.
Revolution's happening right now here.
There you go.